Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sheet Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in for a detailed look at the content of this here box. This box contains the brand new Runcam Split Hybrid 4K, well, combined action camera and FPV camera. So in this video, I'm going to show you what's in this box briefly. Obviously, the main gist of this video is going to be test samples, test videos. And I'm also going to screw this thing into a multirotor. Yeah, why not? I'm going to screw it into a multirotor and we're going to do some flying. Apart from that, I'll tell you what I think of the system. Is there anything missing? Is there anything wrong? And yeah, there is actually something missing from the system and wrong. Well, you'll be the judge. I'll tell you what I think of this system. Let's first have a look at what you get for your money. You obviously get the combined camera and you can see the dual lens setup, and you get a controller board, recorder board with it, with a cable. I'll have a detailed look at that in a second. What you also get is this foam. The camera came packaged in this foam, and this is open cell foam. And don't throw this away instantly. You'll want to use a piece of this, and I'll show you in a second. You get yourselves a nice silicone cable, as always with Runcam cameras, and you use this cable to hook the system up to your flight controller or directly to your VTX. If you'll be running this system in an airplane, maybe you don't have a flight controller, so yeah, straight to your VTX. And these plugs plug into this connector that's, well, wired up to the controller board, as you can tell. It's a 3-pin connector and it's pretty much the same. Well, it's the same as you'd have on all Runcam cameras. So if your quadcopter already has a Runcam or most other FPV cameras, you can simply unplug your FPV camera and use this plug. So that'll work out pretty easily. You won't even have to do any soldering. Okay, mounting hardware, plastic standoffs and screws to mount the camera in your quadcopter. You get a little plastic tab here that will prevent your memory card from flying all out. There's the memory card slot on the recorder board. And you simply mount that plastic slab onto the board like so, and it'll keep your memory card in place in case of a crash. Very good idea, essential basically. The camera system itself then. Here is the camera unit with its two lenses, and yeah, obviously they figured out that they could get away with this lens setup, with the bottom lens being slightly retracted into the camera, or well, the top one poking out a little further. And the top one over here, so this is the top of the camera. The wire comes out at the top. The biggest lens is the HD lens, 4K lens. And they definitely, I hope you'll be able to see that, but they definitely look different. The aperture of these two lenses is different, and the size is different. To my knowledge, the top one is an M12 lens and the bottom one is an M8 lens. There will be specifications of the system in the description of this video. Go check it out. So I'll check the sizes of these lenses. Are they replaceable with, say, lenses for other cameras? I'm sure they are. Will it actually work? I'm not sure. Maybe I'll actually try that bigger angles, especially for the HD recorder. But well, in this video I'm gonna test the camera setup with these two lenses. What you can also see is two mounting holes where the Kydex Touch A has one. Be aware of that. In most frames, I don't think this is a might actually be a benefit. It'll leave you with more choice to position your camera in the frame. Okay, so then there's that cable running from the camera to the recorder board, which is a step up from the older, the flat ribbon cables that were used on other split systems from Runcam. I'd say that this is a lot less fragile. And I don't even mean fragile in the sense that it would get damaged, but the connection could be intermittent in the old split systems. especially if this cable would flop around in the wind. The connector might... Hey, by the way, it also looks... No, it's not glued down. Actually, well, maybe it is. It feels like there's a little bit of silicone holding the cable, securing the cable in place. Interesting. Okay, so then there's this board, which is a 20 by 20 board, which makes sense in most cases, I think. A setup like this is most useful in 3-inch drones, quadcopters, I think, in my humble opinion. So a 20 by 20 stack is usual in those quadcopters. I'd say that if you have a 5-inch quadcopter system like this, it can be used, obviously, but you'd be better off, well, using a separate HD camera, a Runcam 5, for instance. Okay, so this controller board already has a cable on it, power and video out, plus minus video out. Then there's 3 connector points over here, solder pads, and there are 2 over here. Now, this system can actually be set up to use 2 separate UARTs on your flight controller, which is, for me, 2 more than I really want to. You don't need to. The system will work as it is. If you power it, it'll record. But you can use these little solder points at the top right for a camera setup controller. So the little joystick controller boards that come with some FPV cameras. And yes, this FPV camera does not come with one. Or you can hook these 2 up to a UART and control the settings of the FPV camera. Again, the FPV camera can be controlled with a UART hooked up to these solder pads. Then you've got these 3 solder pads, and the third one I actually don't know. Maybe that's for audio, I'm not sure. It's actually undocumented. I'll ask Runcam about that solder pad. Might be, again, audio. This last one is to, again, control the recorder via a UART. So not the setup, but to start and stop recordings from your flight controller. So you can set up a switch on your radio to start and stop the recordings. And I'm not going to do that. I mean, the default setup of this this board is to start recording once it's powered on, and it'll actually save the recording if you simply unhook your battery. So it's a black box setup, which is what I like. I simply always have a recording, and well, if I fly a cinematic quadcopter, usually I do so to make a recording, right? So yeah, to me this, maybe it'll be handy for you. Who knows? You have the option, and that's always nice. And okay, so like I said, is there something missing with this system? Yeah, you don't get the 5-way controller board to change settings of the FPV camera, so the smaller of these cameras. And also, you don't get a pigtail. Some FPV cameras come with a little pigtail, with a blue and a white wire that you can hook up to the camera. And you can simply leave that wire in your quadcopter, right? Actually, I'll show what that looks like in a second. So yeah, that wire is, well, missing. They don't include it, and I think they should. Okay, I'm getting ahead of myself a little here, but this is the quadcopter I'll screw the new Runcam system into. Currently, it has a Caddx Tarjay. And what you see here, that white connector, that is actually the pigtail to control the setup of that FPV camera. So that pigtail, that white little connector over here, is something I would definitely want to see in the Runcam Hybrid as well. And I've already told Runcam, maybe in the production version, they will include a little pigtail with that connector. Maybe even a controller board, so a 5-way joystick. I'll tell them to include that as well, and I really don't know if they will, but yeah. Okay, so, well, that's my stance on that. Okay, enough blah blah without me showing you what the camera can actually do. What you see here is me riding my bicycle, as we do in the Netherlands, in a sunny day. And if you want to have a look at other scenarios or other resolutions, there's a link in the description of this video to my playlist with unedited footage from this system. Go check it out. I've got test recordings with adverse conditions, so in almost rainy days. And I'll have recordings in 2.7K and in 4K. And what you see here, I shot in 2.7K. I think that's the default resolution of this camera, 2.7K, 60 frames a second. And yes, the system can also do 4K, but then at 30 frames a second. So what RunCam tells me is that the HD part of this system is basically a RunCam 5, which seems legitimate, because the RunCam 5 is also a 4K 30 frames a second camera. And it would, I guess it would make sense for them to reuse the same components, same sensor, same lens, and especially because it works, it's a good camera, especially for what it costs. And the FPV part of this system, this hybrid camera, is said to be the RunCam Racer 2. Now, before this camera was released, I actually expected the FPV part of this camera to be the Phoenix camera. Also a new camera recently released, and it has a higher resolution, 1000 TVL. And that is a very cinematic freestyle camera. But I guess they wanted this hybrid system to be more multi-purpose or more all-purpose. So they went with a Racer camera, which is... well, it has a lower latency, so more people would find this camera to be useful. If you want to record races, then this system would actually be useful. And that's not something that goes for any other of the split systems, in my humble opinion. And, well, you can fly this system in forests, for instance, which is definitely not something I'd want to do with a Phoenix camera. Okay, while I was blabbering on, you've had a look at my test footage here. Basically, you tell me what you think. I think this actually does look like the RunCam 5. The HD footage looks very good. Does the FPV feed look very good? Now, I don't think it looks very cinematic, but it looks very usable and in a lot of circumstances. And let's put that to the test. So I'll screw this system into my quadcopter here, this Diatone quadcopter, and we'll do some flying. Here we go. Okay, so here is one of my FPV flights with the hybrid. And if you didn't see this before or didn't realize, the HD recordings of this camera, so the 4K, up to 4K recordings, only have a mild amount of WDR, a wide dynamic range. And that might surprise you, because the FPV feed, which you see in the bottom left, has quite a lot of WDR. And that's, well, I guess that makes sense, because the FPV camera that this hybrid is based on is a Racer 2, and that camera does have WDR. Pretty aggressive at that, and that's basically needed for an FPV camera to be always see where you're going. I hope that makes sense. The HD recording, however, is a bit or a lot more realistic. Is that a fair way to say it? If you look into the sun with this HD camera, you will be, well, not completely blinded. In reality, if you'd be looking into the sun like this, you would be blinded. You wouldn't see anything, any detail you'd want to see. The tree line, for instance, would be black. So again, the HD recording does do a little bit of WDR, just like the RunCam 5, but it's not super aggressive in that sense. And it's also non-configurable. It has one mode, what you see here. Maybe in the future they'll change the firmware on that, but this is what, again, the RunCam 5 does, and this hybrid does it as well. And do you like that? I personally do, but that might be a personal thing. The color reproduction is very realistic, I'd say. Everything that's green in this image is exactly as I'd see it in reality. So that's excellent. And for as far as the FV feed, that's a bit oversaturated. Also a little oversharpened. And personally, I like that. I like the Runcam Racer 2 very much. But that is a personal thing, and it might also depend on your goggles. If the sharpening of your goggle is very pronounced, very strong, mine aren't. I've dialed the sharpening in my goggle down. So yeah, again, it's first of all a personal thing, and second of all, it's based on whether your goggle has a lot of sharpening going on. And you do see in the FPV feed that there is a shimmer of black, a black outline around the white lines in this soccer field. There, you could see it there. And that's basically sharpening. That's all that is. Sharpening is always a contrast enhancement. So yeah, again, I like it. It helps me see where I'm going. So yeah, and that's what I want my FPV camera to do. Alrighty, I enjoyed myself. Well, I pretty much always enjoy myself while flying, but this is an enjoyable camera to use, even in Dutch weather. Now, I've probably already said it in this video, but there's a link in the description to my playlist with unedited footage from this Runcam hybrid camera. I will be adding new videos to that as I'm flying this quadcopter. So yeah, once in a while you'll see new videos pop up in that playlist. I have not shot 4K videos with the camera as of yet. Maybe by the time you are watching this video I have, so take a look at that. And I have to say that I have already ordered a second one of these cameras. I have a similar 3-inch cinematic freestyler from iFlight. So that one is also going to get this hybrid. And what more can I tell you? Yeah, let me show you the setup procedure of this camera. It is actually pretty simple. You've got one Runcam app for all Runcam cameras. Yeah, you heard that right, Foxeer. One app for all cameras. So you start that app and you pick the camera you want to change settings off. As you can see, all Runcam cameras. Cool stuff. So hybrid, there we go. Configure the hybrid. So then you've got options, and I expect there to be more options in the future. Right now it's more or less the same as the Runcam 5, I think. You've got specific settings and general settings. So what you do then is you click apply over here, and what you can also see here is a step-by-step manual, if you will, on how to transfer the settings you've made in the app to your camera. Basically what it tells you is start your camera, so this camera, then stop the recording because the camera will auto start a recording, then press the second button for a couple of seconds, and then show this barcode to the camera, and voila, your settings will be transferred to the camera. Pretty simple. And it's the same as in, like I said, the Runcam 5 action camera, the Cube camera. I quite like this method of setting up your camera. So yeah, the KEDX Touch A has a Wi-Fi app, right? And to use that, you will need to have your quadcopter powered on the entire time you're changing settings. All the while burning up your VTX and such. It does work. And yeah, maybe you prefer that method. I quite like this, it works for me. Then again, how often do you change settings? In general, I think most people will experiment a while with the settings, and at a certain point you'll have a favorite set of settings, a favorite resolution and such, and after that you don't use the settings method anymore as much. So maybe it's not that important. What is important is that this setup is a little lighter. It only has one board, and that's probably due to it not having a Wi-Fi module, right? The Caddx CRC has a Wi-Fi module which it has to slug around, and that's probably the second board in that setup. I'm not sure, but I think it is. Also, the starting and stopping of videos is super simple. Generally, when I pick up the quad after a flight, like so, I can easily click the stop record button, which is over here, in one go. Super duper simple. And yeah. Okay, so the user interface for me is very nice. And that is my review of the Runcam Hybrid for now. As I said, I will be using it more, obviously, and I've got a second one on the way. And maybe I'll have a long-term review in a while. What I will definitely have is a giveaway. So if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do, so you won't miss out on my giveaway. Also, be sure to ring that notifications bell over there, so you won't miss the video. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.